So ninth class, we are to start the part two of cyber safety. Okay. First concept is malware. What is malware? Now, malware actually is a combination of two words. One is malicious, one is software. Such softwares which are harmful, which may be illegal, and which can cause disruption in our normal working in computer, which disturbs our normal operations, which affects the normal working of computer system. Which produce uncertain effects, which are not required. All those softwares, all those malicious codes, all those malicious softwares collectively are known as malware. Malware is a general term. It signifies all type of malicious softwares. It includes virus, worms, Trojan horse, your spyware, adware, ransomware, phishing, denial of services. Each and every software with malicious intention, with a malicious intent, is included under the term malware. Am I clear? The next concept is PPT visible clearly, all of you? The next concept is types of malware. So what are the various types of malware? What are the various type of malicious softwares which are considered to be malware? Virus, just you have biological virus. Hum jab bimar padte hain, we say virus has infected us. One is biological virus, which affects the human body. One is computer virus, which affect the working conditions of system. Worms, Trojan horse, phishing, okay, ransomware, adware, spyware, all these are various types of malwares. Now, first we have to study is virus. Generally speaking, virus ki koi shape nahi hai, Lavanya, please focus here. Virus has no particular shape. You can't say this is a structure of virus. It shows its presence by negative effects. How do we get to know that virus has entered into our system? When our system start producing negative effects, wrong symptoms. Okay, files delete ho jati hain. System processing becomes very slow. Abrupt messages start coming. Right? System starts keep on hanging. Right? So all these things, all these negative effects, they signify the occurrence of the malicious software known as virus. Do you know the full form of virus? Vital information resource under siege. Vital information resource under siege. S-E-I-Z-E. This is the full form of virus. Okay. Now virus requires a host program. In order to activate itself, वायरस को किसी और प्रोग्राम की जरूरत पड़ती है. When it takes the host program, it copies its coding into that host program. And then that coding travels in all the files. And your files come corrupted. Your files get corrupted. Okay? Next is worms. The strongest feature of worms is it does not require any host program. It does not require any host program to activate itself. It is self-replicating. Self-replicating means once it enters, it starts spreading itself on its own. Virus needs a host program to activate. Worm does not need any host program to activate. This is the strongest difference between virus and worm. And worm attack is mainly on the disk space. Your memory space gets affected by the occurrence of worm. Now comes Trojan horse, the most dangerous type of malicious software. You know the story behind it? Do you know the story, the real story, why it is named as Trojan horse? Yeah, in 7 months I told you, I repeat it so many years back. Actually, in the past time, during the mythological periods, there was a war between Greek and Trojans. The people of Trojans, they were known as Troy. Troy was the city. The people were known as Trojans. Troy was the city and the people were known as Trojans. So there was war between Greeks and Trojans. So what Greeks did, they planned something malicious. With some wrong intent, what they did, they show that as if they have gone away from there. Wo chale gaye wahan se. They have left that place and they have gone, but they created a wooden horse, a big size wooden horse they created, and some soldiers were hide inside that wooden horse. Ek secret darwaza tha us bade sare ghode ke andar, aur us darwaze ke andar unhone apne kuch soldiers ko chupa diya tha. And they left that horse at the gate of Troy city, the main entrance gate of Troy city, and they showed as if they have gone away, Greeks. So Troyans, when they opened the gate and they saw that wooden horse, they felt very glad that we have won the battlefield and this horse is a symbol of our victory. So they dragged that horse into their area. They were not knowing that it contains the group of soldiers who are ready to attack on them. When they brought that horse in the city, that soldiers who were hiding, they suddenly attack on them. And Greeks who pretend that as if we have gone, they also attack. They also came and they also attack and they destroy the whole Troy city. From there, it got the name Trojan horse. Trojan horse actually means one, koi aisi cheez jo saamne bilkul theek lage, saamne achhi lage, par back end pe wo apna negative effect create kar rahi. Like I give one live example to you. You rely lot on your friend, but your friend is betraying you. At your backside, your friend is putting complaints against you to the teachers, but in front of you, your friend appears very helpful. That I am very helpful to you. I am good friend to you. Okay. But at the backside, your friend is playing the negative role. Instigating teachers against you, complaining against you, but you are unaware about it. Suddenly you get the negative effects. Teacher starts scolding you. Okay. And you get very disturbing atmosphere. You feel very disturbed. Similar to this live example is the effect of Trojan horse. In front, it appears to be very useful, very legitimate. Legitimate means legal. But at the back end, it is destroying your files. It is corrupting your system. And the main cause of Trojan horse is via email attachments. So it is always recommended, never open attachment at once. Okay, scan it properly. Right? Next is spyware. Spy. I am spying on some person. Jise aap Hindi mein jasoosi kehte ho. So a software which is keeping a spy on you. Whatever activities you are performing, somebody is spying on you, keeping record of all your activities, keeping an eye on you. And whatever work you are performing, whatever activities you are performing, each and every report is being given to the third party. Maybe third party is giving some payment to him. कि आप मेरे लिए ये काम करो, मैं आपको इतने पैसे दूंगा. ओके, रैंसम वेयर. ओके, जनरल मीनिंग ऑफ रैंसम, ब्राइब, रिश्वत. आई गिव वन लाइव एग्जाम्पल टू यू एंड यू विल गेट टू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ रैंसम. आई एक्टिंग एज मलेशियस पर्सन, आई स्टील सम इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स ऑफ राघव. ओके, is just an example. Okay, don't get worried. And he got very worried and very afraid and threatened that I have lost my important personal documents, they can be misused and all and all. So I called him up and I say, I will release your documents, I will give your photographs and everything back, but you have to give me some payment. Mujhe itne paise do aur main aapke ye sare wapas kar dunga. This is ransomware. अब इस live example को अपने lecture में ले आओ. All your personal information is stolen by someone, is hacked by someone, and that malicious person threatens you, message you, and ask for a big amount of ransom. And threatens also that if you will not give, I'll destroy them. And you will be the loser. Okay, so this is ransomware. Yeah, all these malicious softwares, they are created by persons only. Attackers are there or sitting online. Adware. Yeah, this is a very general type of malicious software. Daily we come across it. When you open any website, have you seen some message comes, allow and block? Pop-ups want to come, allow, block. When we open any app on smartphone, this app wants to use your contact, allow, deny, like this. All these pop-up messages, they are the advertisements, the bulk advertisements. Okay, this is adware. Right? Bulk of advertisements in form of pop-up, they appear on the computer screen. Right? Now, what are the various type of damages that are caused by the malware? Online class, am I clear up till here? Tanveen, Gurupal, Krishna, all of you give your feedback quickly. Just wait. Let me have confirmation from the online. Dhwani, Gurleen, your feedback is not coming. All right. Yes, Rahul. Your voice is not audible to me. All right. Now, what are the damages caused by virus? It deletes your files, damages your files. The PC becomes slow in working. PC लेट शुरू होता है, स्टार्ट भी लेट हो रहा है, धीरे धीरे प्रोसेसिंग हो रही है, फाइल्स लेट खुल रही हैं, ओके? इनवेड योर ईमेल प्रोग्राम, इट अटैक्स योर ईमेल आईडीज, इट कैन हैक योर ईमेल आईडीज, योर पासवर्ड्स, कैन यूज योर ईमेल आईडी टू सेंड ईमेल टू सम अदर पर्सन, टू सम रॉन्ग ईमेल्स टू सम अदर पर्संस, कॉम्प्रोमाइज योर डाटा एंड कंप्यूटिंग हैबिट्स, कीप्स अ रिकॉर्ड ऑफ व्हाटएवर एक्टिविटीज यू आर डूइंग ऑन द कंप्यूटर लाइक स्पाईवेयर, ओके? Alter the PC settings. Settings gets changed in the PC. Right? What you have done, it gets altered to that. Right? Adware track information. I told you, bulk of advertisements you start getting. Now, safety measures. How you can prevent occurrence of malware. Now, safety measures will be studying under two categories. Active protection, okay, and next is our prevention measures. The most important is we must always install antivirus into our system. A good antivirus, and we should regularly scan our system. देखो ये सब जनरल पॉइंट्स हैं. इट्स नॉट एनी हार्ड एंड फास्ट रूल कि जो टाइप मैंने किया है आपको ब्लाइंडली वो पढ़ना. यू एनहांस योर ओन स्किल्स. डोंट जस्ट रिलाय ऑन पीपीटी. यूज योर ओन स्किल्स. यूज योर ओन थिंकिंग. अपनी थिंकिंग स्किल्स बढ़ाओ. आप कंप्यूटर यूज करते हो. यू आर अ स्टूडेंट, 10th क्लास स्टूडेंट. डेली यू यूज द स्मार्टफोन्स. यू आर वेरी मच एक्सपर्ट ऑन सोशल मीडियाज. So how you can prevent malwares? Think for so many reasons you will, so many points you will get. Install good antivirus. Regularly scan your system. Keep backup of the important data. Why we keep the backup of important data? In case we lost the original, we have the duplicate. Right? Then frequent run your antivirus and keep your antivirus up to date. Whenever we download some apps, after frequent intervals, we have to update those apps so that all the recent changes, they get incorporated into that. Otherwise, hum purane version mein kaam karte rahenge. Jo bhi latest changes hue hain, wo kabhi hume mil nahi payenge. We won't be able to get that. Okay, clear? Got it? So, never use pirated softwares. Use softwares from legal websites. When you are accessing internet, do check that HTTPS is written over there. What is HTTPS? Secure. We are under secure environment. Okay. The connection between the client and the server is secure. Okay. So always do the browsing in secure environment. Never share your passwords with others. Never share OTPs. This can also be your safety measure. Okay, clear? Now comes the topic cyber crime. By name, it is very much clear. Any crime that takes place by using technologies might be internet. Might be smartphone. Okay. Using these modern technologies, any crime committed that harms someone, that comes under the term cyber crime. Right? So what all is covered under cyber crime? What type of criminal activities are included under the term cyber crime? Phishing, just karan jaag jao neend se. Credit card frauds, go and wash your face. Go and wash your face. Phishing is that you receive the fraudulent emails, fraud emails from unknown persons you get. Okay. And your passwords are cracked. Debit card information is stolen. Credit card information is stolen. Okay. Illegal downloading. You download the files from untrusted websites. The website was illegal and you download some material from there. Cyber bullying. Abhi hum padhenge detail mein. Cyber stalking, cyber terrorism. Right. And the last one is creation and distribution of virus. Now, let us study the broader term cyberbullying. I explain in a very simple way what is cyberbullying. Humne kisi ko bahut zyada disturb kiya. I give a live example, okay? We disturb some person and we are continuously disturbing him to such an extent that excess pressure is created on that person. Wo person itna frustrated ho chuka hai, wo itne pressure mein aa chuka hai that he start thinking negative. to such an extent he think negative that he comes up to destroy his or her life. This is harassment. This is harassment. हम कहते नहीं मुझे हरास कर रहे हैं, मेरे पे इतना प्रेशर डाल रहे हैं, मुझे इतना काम दे रहे हैं, मुझे हरास कर रहे हैं. Defaming. We are doing such activities. हम ऐसे काम कर रहे हैं जो किसी की रेपुटेशन को डाउन कर रहे हैं. Daily, I give an example. A teacher is there. A is a teacher and B is a student. Teacher A is daily speaking negative about student B in the class. Teacher A is defaming the reputation of student B. उसकी इमेज को खराब कर रहे हैं. इंटीमिडेटिंग, अपना एक ऐसा ऑरा बनाया, यू क्रिएट थ्रेटन इन द हार्ट ऑफ अदर्स. बच्चा कहता है मुझे ना इस टीचर से बहुत डर लगता है, मुझे इस टीचर से बहुत डर लगता है. वो टीचर ने, वो पर्सन ने अपना ऐसा प्रेजेंस शो की हुई है कि वो किसी के दिल में डर पैदा कर रहा है. Intimidating comes in two ways, positive also, negative also. अगर negative की बात करूं, it means you threaten someone, you create fear in heart of someone by your presence, कि आपको देखकर ही उसे डर लगना शुरू हो जाए. If comes in positive sense, you like one teacher a lot. When the teacher comes in front of you, you get happy, your mind gets glad, ki ye mera favorite teacher hai. You get positive vibes from there. You show high degree of respect. This is my favorite teacher. Isko dekh ke mere ko positive vibes aa rahe hain. Jaise koi bahut acha friend hai aapka. You have one of your very good friend. Whenever he comes home, you feel very delighted. You get very excited ki mera ye wala friend ghar aaya. Right? So it comes in two ways. Now this harassing, defaming, demeaning, intimidating, all this includes cyber bullying. Ye bahut bada cyber crime hai. If the victim reports in the cyber law, heavy imprisonment or heavy fine of in lakhs is imposed on the attacker. So it is always recommended, always told, never try to defame anyone publicly, especially on internet. Facebook pe hum status dalte hain. Some persons, they wrote so negative. You take all these sites which are generally used by the persons. Facebook pe kitni social profiles bani hui hain. And people, they wrote lot of negativity, negative points also. We should not write such negativities, especially in the social media. That can disturb the mind of any person. Hum kisi ko bahut disturb kar rahe hain, hum daily kisi ko harass kar rahe hain, aur wo person itna harass ho gaya, itna disturb ho gaya, that person finally decides to end his life. He committed suicide. क्योंकि उसके ऊपर इतना एक्सेस प्रेशर आ गया, वो इतना डिस्टर्ब हो गया, उसकी रेपुटेशन बिल्कुल खत्म हो गई. कॉन्टिन्यूसली उसको थ्रेटन्स आ रहे हैं, वार्निंग्स आ रही हैं, उसको ऐसा एनवायरमेंट दिया गया है कि वो डिस्टर्ब हो चुका है, बिल्कुल डिप्रेशन में चला गया. एंड डिप्रेशन गोज टू सच एन एक्सटेंट दैट पर्सन हैज नो सोल्यूशन लेफ्ट. So we should always take care of this thing, that we should never, never try to. Who is this Gaganpreet? We should never, ever write anything on social media that disturbs somebody's reputation that disturbs somebody's mind. Right? Now, cyber stalking and cyber bullying, almost they are same, with a very light difference. Otherwise, the main meaning is same. Somebody follows you. Again, I give live example over here. Somebody follows you. आप जहां जा रहे हो आपके पीछे आपको लग रहा है कि कोई पीछा कर रहा है आपका. आप मार्केट जा रहे हो आपको लग रहा है ऐसा फील हो रहा है somebody is following me. कोई मेरा पीछा कर रहा है मेरे पे नजर रख रहा है मुझे स्टॉक कर रहा है. आजकल ये बड़ा कॉमन वर्ड चल रहा है सीरियल्स में मुझे स्टॉक किया जा रहा है. राइट हम ये नहीं कहते आपने सोशल मीडिया पे किसको स्टॉक किया. हम कहते हैं नॉर्मली है स्टॉक मींस विजिट किया किसकी प्रोफाइल विजिट की. मैंने इसकी प्रोफाइल को स्टॉक किया मैंने इसकी प्रोफाइल को स्टॉक किया मैंने इसकी प्रोफाइल को स्टॉक किया. नजर रखे हुए हैं फॉलोइंग समवन इन नेगेटिव सेंस इन ऑर्डर टू हैरास दैट पर्सन. वी आर सेंडिंग ईमेल्स टू दैट पर्सन. We have kept so much information about that person. हमने उस person के बारे में सारी information रखी हुई है. वो कहाँ जाता है कहाँ रहता है कितने बजे घर से निकलता है where he goes what time he come back. Okay, his phone number his email ID his address and then we are sending emails to him. We are sending warnings to him. We are sending fearful messages to him. Again harassing, again cyber crime. Okay. Now, how cyber stalker troubles, how an attacker, a cyber stalker troubles you. Collect information about the victim. Victim means जिसके ऊपर attack हुआ. Right? Post the information on illegal websites. The person collected your information. Your photograph, your address, your phone number, every detail about you, and create a fake profile on wrong website. Galat website pe aapka sara data dal diya. And persons, when they see that website, they read your information, they start calling you. Fake calls you start getting. You are unaware about it. But once it is reported to cyber law, immediate action is taken. And heavy imprisonment, heavy fine is imposed on that person. आजकल बहुत जल्दी ये चीजों का पता लगाया जा सकता. Okay? Then victim receives unsolicited emails. When we don't know the sender, we say unsolicited emails. आपको WhatsApp पे एक मैसेज आया अननोन नंबर से. अब यही कहते हैं पहली बात ये किसका नंबर है. आई डोंट नो द पर्सन हु इज दिस. इफ मैसेज इज नेगेटिव वी ऑलवेज ब्लॉक द पर्सन. देन समटाइम व्हाट हैपन टीनेजर्स ये ज्यादातर टीनेजर्स ही करते हैं ये प्रॉब्लम्स. योर फ्रेंड वॉन्ट टू प्ले प्रैंक विद यू. वो आपके साथ मजाक कर रहा है. उसने आपको एक नंबर से मैसेज किया 5-10 मिनट आपको डराता रहा एंड यू गेट अफ्रेड फ्राइटेंड सडनली ही सेज आई एम दिस. दिस शुड नॉट बी डन. ये भी गलत है. यू नेवर नो व्हेन योर मैसेज क्रिएट सो मच ऑफ ट्रबल इन समबडीज हार्ट दैट पर्सन गेट इनटू डिप्रेशन. उसको चक्कर ही आ जाए बेचारे को. ये होता है. एवरी पर्सन इज नॉट सेम. सो मेनी पर्सन्स दे आर सेंसिटिव बाय नेचर दैट इवन फॉर वन रॉन्ग मैसेज दे गेट सो थ्रेटन्ड. What about the condition if they receive bulk of such messages? Every person is not strong enough. Nature and temperament of every person is different. A teacher is teaching in the class. It is not 100% perfection ki everybody likes that teacher. There may be one or two students who didn't understand the concept of that teacher. There may be a chance the entire class loved that teacher. Okay. So nature and temperament of every person is different. So we should not involve ourselves in any such type of act that disturbs someone. Our single negative trial can bring somebody's life to problem. So we should avoid all this. Okay. Now, what we should do if such things happen to us? How to report for cybercrime? But all these can come as MCQs, as case studies. Right? What should be done when we get prone, when we become victim of cybercrime? First, we should talk to our parents, our school teachers, our school authorities. Then we should file the FIR. First work is discuss with your parents. कि मेरे को ऐसी प्रॉब्लम आ रही है, मुझे ऐसे मैसेज आ रहे हैं, और पेरेंट्स को मैसेज दिखाओ. Then talk to your school teachers. If problem occurs in school, immediately talk to principal. Immediately talk to the teachers. Take help from teachers. Discuss the problem with your teacher. Don't hesitate to discuss your problem with teachers. Teachers are like your parents. So always feel free to discuss your problems with the teacher. You can't discuss in the class, go personally. Wake up, ma'am. Then, if problem is not sorted out, then go to police. Approach the police stations which is nearby your area and file the FIR over there. If you can't go to police station, you can file the FIR electronically using online methods. That is called EFIR, Electronic First Investigation Report. Then Ministry of Home Affairs, they are also launching the websites where all the victims, like any woman, any children who are prone to be victim of cybercrime, they can report their problem, they can report their FIR over there. They can lodge their complaint over there. Okay? Got it? Completely online class, am I clear? Yes, online students, am I clear with the lecture? All right.